all the class 12 students of the Waldorf system do a project of their interest or anything that they want to know more of, and they prepare a whole paper about it. And of course, they have a lot of, they go through a process in the end with a lot of realizations. And most importantly, we see who they are through the project. So this is the most significant experience of their last year in the Waldorf system. And so they always shine. All of our grade 12 students shine in the senior project presentation. So we want to share this with you, dear parents, friends, and students, of course, who are also going through this process in the coming years. So we will start with our first speaker, Alex Abo-Hamda.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Alex Abo-Hamda, and today I'm going to share with you my discoveries in dance. I will report how I was able to show the importance of dance, as well as how to choreograph, by experiencing space in different ways. At first, I wanted to pursue something practical for my project, such as what I plan to take up in college. But I realized this year would be heavy on academics, so I needed a project that would get me off the computer and make me move physically. More importantly, I wanted a hands-on project that relied less on research and more on my own experiences. With this in mind, dance was the obvious choice. Dance has been with me almost my whole life. What constitutes dance? Dance can be defined as moving rhythmically to music, but is that really all there is to it? I hope to explore dance and search for a deeper meaning to it. In the history of dance in its earliest form, dance was called, believe it or not, religion. Back then, there would only be dancing when there was a victory from war, a good harvest, or anything worth praising. This went on until the Greek period, which now also incorporated drama into dance, aside from religion. But the Greek god most praised was the god of drama, Dionysus, better known as the god of wine and ecstasy. Later, I found that ecstasy actually means to stand outside yourself. Is dance then the act of giving a message or receiving one? During the Renaissance, dance gained social purpose by creating alliances between royalty and the ballroom. This eventually led to the greatest moment in dance, when the whole theater filled up to see one dancer perform, the prima ballerina. Ballet set the fundamentals of all dances today. However, in the 19th century to the present, some dancers felt that dance had become a lifeless structure. Famous dancers like Isadora Duncan and Martha Graham, to name a few, strived to return dance to its sacred form, giving dance natural methods as opposed to set patterns as found in ballet. Such natural methods intrigued me, especially in their use of space. Space can be experienced at many levels, and I'm not talking about outer space. Space, in the Oxford Dictionary, is defined as a continuous area or expanse, which is free, available, or unoccupied. It is also defined as the dimensions of height, depth, and width within which all things exist and move. I wanted to search beyond the dictionary's definition. I just had to find the meaning of the fascinating art that is dance. But I also wanted to answer my one frustration with dance, which is, how can I choreograph in a way that somehow connects to how one uses one's space? So to sum it all up, my thesis is, how can I experience space, apply it through choreography, and in doing so, understand the importance of dance? Picture yourself waking up in a room, feeling light as a feather, that you can resist gravity without effort. Imagine being able to hold on to walls and floating gently off the ground and up to the ceiling. This video is called Weightless by Erica Yanunger. Here, the dancers move as if to defy gravity throughout the space of the room. After watching that video, I also wanted to experience moving in space the way they did. I wanted to explore this notion of space in different ways, which most may merely perceive as a void. I was also inspired by the book of Paulo Coelho entitled The Witch of Portobello. The protagonist, Athena, uses dance to channel herself into her center and touch her spiritual side. It also contains several views on space, spaces between words, spaces between people, spaces being rushed, and even the spaces in life. Lastly, I was fortunate enough to go to the Gurbianum in Switzerland, where I participated in a body contact improvisation workshop. This opened my eyes to how sacred dance could actually be. So now begins my search of dance. The first part of my project was experiencing the physical. Inspired by the video, the book, and the workshop, I set out to experience space in various ways. This was only possible by changing the way I normally move. My dance classes enabled me to feel an immersion of myself in varied levels of height. These encounters with dance I classified as lower, middle, and upper space. In the three-day workshop I attended with Yasmin Kastens in Switzerland, I expected a class that would teach me how to improvise. Instead, I learned to move in a most liberating way, dictated by nothing but impulse. This was the most unique way I've ever been taught to move. It didn't even feel like dancing. To give you an idea, she first told us to pair up, lie down, and feel our weight sink to the ground. Your partner must also put their weight on you. Your partner will manipulate the body lying down by dragging and rolling over, gradually shifting to movements like kneeling and then standing. I had to let any force my partner would give affect me and pass it on to the next movement. Since most of this work was on the floor, I call this experiencing the lower space. Another time, I took contemporary dance, which is an altered ballet in a very modern genre. It shows an outpouring of emotion. The movements are all elongated, from leaping around the room to collapsing on the floor. In this class, I had to add my own flair to the moves and transitions. Along with the emotion, however, is an intense conditioning of the body. I had to fix my posture, my pointing, my core, and alignment. Experiencing space laterally in contemporary dance, I call middle space. My next goal was to experience literally height. Have you ever dreamed of flying like a gymnast, Cirque du Soleil? I wanted to feel suspended in air, so I took aerial silks with Polkats Manila. Here, I learned how to manipulate the silks to create poses and forms. If dance cannot be captured in a moment, here, you could suspend all four limbs at once for as long as your muscles will carry you. Although it has the added beauty of silk, it demands much upper body strength, which is bizarre to usual dancing that usually requires leg muscles. It is extending oneself, moving between the floor and the ceiling, giving the audience a top-to-bottom view. I had never danced dependent on another medium, nor in mid-air, which is why I call this exposure upper space. In my quest to learn more about dance at a deeper level, I watched a Martha Graham technique class video, wherein I picked up a few more hints as to what dance might mean. Quoting from the video, movement language is based on the expressive capacity of the human body. The body speaks the image, and the language must be articulate. And this is why flexibility and conditioning have always been so crucial, because if I can reach farther or leap higher, this would broaden my vocabulary of dance. I interviewed Mr. Pablo Corman, a priest from the Christian community, who was a Broadway dancer and choreographer in New York in his early years. One of the things he said that struck me most was not to use mirrors, because one can become so focused on the form instead of expressing feeling. This idea changed my entire perception of choreographing because I've been doing it my whole life. I realized that when I danced in front of a mirror, I felt disconnected and fixed on the image or moves I saw in the mirror. I became stuck in what I called flat space. cut space isn't real space. My experience of depth was compromised by the mirror. Aside from this, it inhibited my ability to feel myself moving in space. From then on, I didn't dance with mirrors unless I was cleaning or refining my moves. At this point, I realized that dance is communication. It is giving a message to the audience. In the furtherance of the communication between dancer and audience, choreography plays a vital role in ensuring that the message delivery is as clear as possible. My experiences in the use of space were key to doing better choreography and thus more effective message delivery. But dance is also communicating to something immaterial. To go further, I explored the inner feeling or relief of happiness one experiences in dance. It was time for me to start creating my own choreography. I knew from the beginning that there isn't a single way to choreograph a song. Several dancers interpret songs in various ways, so I just had to start. I came to my first piece having little time. This benefited me in a sense that it gave me no time to overthink it at all. For my Michaelmas number, I danced to Lady Gaga and I choreographed the verses. Pressured by time, I made the moves very simple, and for the first time, I felt okay with it. In fact, it didn't occur to me after a week that I had somehow infused a meaning into my choreography. So I deciphered the rest of what the song meant, and I choreographed with that. Marry the Night was how I needed to marry the darkness and come out strong. Applause, the number with a group, was my perspective on how fame can be alluring, addicting, and hard to let go. Beginning, the movements are distorted, finding our way to fame. And in the lower space, feeling inferior to those who have it. Chorus, we have the applause, we love it, and become confident, shifting movements to the upper space. After that, movements round, because there arises a doubt that the fame is doing harm. But, after that, popularity intoxicates us once more, and we never stop succumbing to it. We can easily still be a groupie of someone famous, despite being famous ourselves. This was the moral I infused into the choreography. Many people expressed that the performance was good, and that made me optimistic. But sooner or later, I had to watch it for myself. So I evaluated my video 2 weeks later and was quite unsatisfied. Not with the choreography though, but rather my performance. I observed that my body showed confidence, but my gaze did not. It seemed like I was rushing from one move to the next, resulting in the moves being unclear. The dance appeared overly stuffed with moves that were only partially seen. In all of it, I also felt that there was a lack of connection. Perhaps this was the group to each other, or that each of us was still concerned with his or her form and didn't really let go. This brought to mind and proved what Pablo told me, that in dance, you expose yourself. The next piece I choreographed was my artistic presentation, but my foot had a wart from October to early January, limiting all my movement. Also, I couldn't choose a song. It seemed that if there wasn't any meaning tied to the song, I couldn't choreograph. So I experimented with other methods. I listened to all the minimal sounds in the background. I tried moving very minimally to see how my body responds to the music. Project or jerk sharp to create clear lines and do it quickly to transfer myself purely into the song. It was odd, it was fun, but I needed to be reassured, so I interviewed several choreographers on what their methods were. And it turns out a lot of their methods were similar to mine. I went back to my notes with Yasminka's stance. I asked her, why do we dance if these movements aren't so natural? She answered, dancing is very natural. We fulfill this deep wish to move, because when we move, we feel us. We're saying yes to us. Choreograph, she suggested I pick a move I like and clean it until I reach the deepest quality of movement. So I asked her, how will I know that I've reached the deepest quality of movement? And she said, it's about trust. You will know everything about a movement in the moment there is no more doubt. Only when I started dancing for myself did I understand what she meant. My challenges with regards to choreographing was my tendency to make it complex, and it rooted in three things. First, I was in the flat space, creating movements without feeling. Second, I rushed and tried to fill all the spaces. Third, I kept trying to search for the right movements, and there is no right movement. Just because my thoughts are mixed with emotion or unconfirmed doesn't mean they're not true. I realize my own truth varies from others, and all truths can coexist with my own. Choreography is creating a sequence of planned steps. This is just one aspect under the big umbrella of dance. Dance in general can be improvised. Earlier I asked, what constitutes dance? Is dance just moving rhythmically to music? My exploration of dance and search for a deeper meaning to share with you all has led me to the following realizations. Dance is ecstasy. By this, I mean to stand outside yourself, to see yourself. What is the self? I believe it is a composition of the encounters, relationships, goals, and troubles that we have. There is a unique combination for each person, and those turn into habits, and traits, and qualities, and this is how I am known as myself. But do I know myself? The self is determined by my plight. Have to let go of the self, then I can view myself objectively. In dance, there is no pretense. Everything is live, and how I am is exposed. Next, dance is a soul balancer. Dance is that intersection of the physical and the spiritual. The soul mediates and affects the two. So in dance, I celebrate my body, I can also feel an external spirit of myself, and this is how the intersection crosses. With me, I know I tend to delve too much into theories, and I believe dance balances my soul by letting me experience what's concrete. I believe it is in the physical where things are experienced, and the spiritual where those experiences are manifested into ideas to do more, and the cycle goes on. Third, dance teaches me to be in the moment. Any dance teaches me how to appreciate time. When I dance, I can savor every second. If I am not in that very moment or look away to now, I might miss something. A speaker in Dornak last summer described time as me standing in a river, where a stream from the past flows carrying gratitude along with it, and a stream coming towards me from the future, carrying with it possibilities. I am thankful for the fact that my body has been gifted with the ability to dance, as well as the potential of being more adept, to be more creative. I've learned that time is not well spent by filling all the spaces, by filling each moment with achievements to please others. Time is being able to stop once in a while, reflect and feel the moment, soak in the sight and the sounds. I love dancing, for I can glide, scoop, take time into the beauty of the moment, and enjoy it. Lastly, dance is loving and trusting yourself. This year was completely dark for me, and one of the reasons I was able to overcome it was because of dance. I'm constantly wondering if I'm correct or good enough. I realized why I love dancing so much. Because when I dance, that's me. I feel all aspects of myself. I'm acknowledging my importance and my presence. I want to be me. And this appreciation of the self becomes uncontainable, that I have to spread it out. So that concludes my project. I would like to thank everyone who came today to watch. It's a Sunday, and yeah, I know it's quite difficult to come. And anyone who shared the dance fever with me, like the Gaga group that I forced to dance. I would like to thank my sponsors, the Lolit, Miss Camille, and also Miss Dintin for always helping the class get through with the project. I would like to thank my advisors, Ms. Yasmin Castens and Ms. Jackie Asilio, my editor for creating my speech, my ever patient mentor, Ms. Isa Belmonte, who has shared my passion and helped me with the best research material for helping me pursue dance, especially giving me this specific journey because I wanted to do something else and she told me to do this. It turns out it was really much better than what I wanted. And for being my constant support. And of course, the loving support of my dad, my mom, for paying for all my classes and buying my gear and giving me the car to go to class. And Amira for my hair and makeup. And for taking all my videos and my shots. Thank you. Yeah. So, for my artistic, dance is a conversation. I will show you this conversation that was happening in my head throughout the year. Listen to the chorus that says, "Though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our bodies safe to shore." Watch how I have found myself for my own truth.